Hey guys, it's John with Green Fish Nation. I want to welcome you to today's video. If you guys want to learn how to get organized, hang around right here at Green Fish Nation. We're going to show you how to become a better fisherman. All right guys, today we're going to be talking about organization. And it doesn't matter if you have this for a tackle box or this for a tackle box. Both of them need to be organized. Guys, it doesn't matter if you're fishing from the bank or if you're fishing from the boat. When you're more organized, you're going to be a more successful fisherman. You're going to have a better chance to catch more fish because you're going to be spending less time digging through your tackle box, digging through your boat. So it's real important that you know where everything is at. That's one thing that I've tried to do here. This is my son's backpack tackle box. He's primarily a bank fisherman. He has all his gear in here. He has an extra line, he has an extra reel. He keeps all of his baits in separate boxes like crankbaits, chatterbaits, jerkbaits, plastic worms, hooks, and weights. It's all individually divided up in here. And as you can see, this thing has got multiple pockets. It's easy to carry. I have one of these that I carry just like this. When I'm a co-angler with somebody, this is what I try to carry. It's easy to stow in any of the compartments, guys. I can't emphasize enough how much organization is key to being efficient on the water, whether you're on the bank or on the boat. Some of the ways that we stay organized on our boat is you'll see in our compartments, we have rod socks. Other things that we do is we keep our tackle labeled in individual tackle boxes in its own compartment. We have other places for our immediate needs when we're fishing a tournament. We have our scales, our culling beam, our identity markers for our fish. It's all right here in front of us in the live well, right in front of the live well, I should say. We also keep all of our life jackets and our other gear in our other side box. Also, you need to protect your investment. You need to make sure that you keep your, I call them road covers, sun covers on your electronics, because Lord knows they cost almost as much as the boat. Take good care of that stuff. Keep your trolling motor prop cleaned off. Make sure you got all the debris and the line off of that. It'll make all your equipment last longer. Another thing we do is we'll walk back here to the back of the boat and I'll show you. We have the steering protectors for our hydraulic steering. It keeps our motor from swinging side to side when we go down the road. And also we have the motor sticks, I believe they're called. Those hold our motor up, keep it from going down on us, leaking hydraulically or anything like that. Just saves those hydraulics over time, guys. Another thing I like to do, I want to point out right here on my fishing chair, which I don't use a whole lot in the fishing chair, but when I do, I have a kind of a cup holder, scent holder, keep my pliers and my scents and all that stuff right there handy. I hope you've enjoyed today's video. Out here and it's hard to hear, guys. I apologize for that. We got a front moving through Texas right now. We're trying to get ready to get out on the lake in the morning. But I want to thank you again for joining us here on how to become a better fisherman. So you guys stay tuned for future episodes. I'm your host, John, with Green Fish Nation. Tight lines, guys.